Hey guys, I am back in Washington after Parents Weekend, and guess what? We have got helicopters coming to the U.S. Capitol. Probably Blackhawks, probably in the next 20 minutes or so, and I think they're going to land. Let's go.
So I'm currently in Colorado Springs because my truck died on me in New Mexico. And when I say my truck died, my transfer case just started dumping so much gear oil that I had to stop every 80 miles for a 400 mile trip to make my way here. It took 2 days to go 400 miles. It was brutal. And I'm still working on the truck right this minute. So I've been stuck for several days now. But when this video popped up this morning, I had to plug in my microphone and get this out because it really made me sad that so many people covered this topic and then just moved on like it wasn't real. This is a huge deal. This is a huge deal. Posse Comitatus was in effect for 143 years to prevent government from putting U.S. military of any type on the ground, and certainly they did not have the right to fire on American citizens. Well, now, as of September 27th, 2024, they are allowed to fire on American citizens. And when they say they can use lethal force, that means everything. Do you see what I'm saying? That means drones, etc. Does any of this starting to ring a bell? I mean, it's early, but is any of this starting to ring a bell?
I have two words for you. Predator drones. You will never see it coming.
So what I have gathered from this morning is they are doing a evacuation, air assault, etc. at the Capitol. And people that have worked there for a long, long time say they have never seen anything like this before, ever. Now think about this. With less than a month before a ridiculous election, they decide that on the 24th of September, 3 days before this, on the 24th, they're going to start pushing for a 28th Amendment to the Constitution of the United States, which, in case half of Congress suddenly gets wiped out in a mass casualty event, I mean, that's a crazy thing to even say, but okay. If half of Congress gets wiped out in a mass casualty event amid rising political tension, meaning the shit they've been stirring up on television, they can be replaced without any special elections or things of that nature, which means they can take all their boys and put them in there right over and then literally take over the country completely. But that is exactly what's happening anyway. This isn't a fear-mongering thing. This stuff is right here. I mean, what else do you possibly need? Seriously. And people just don't seem to think this is a thing. They've been warning this. They've been warning us about this forever. And their favorite way to do it is in things like this. An entire movie called Leave the World Behind that was put out at the very end of 2023, which literally shows everything I've ever talked about in a video in actual effect. Do you see what I mean? They cut off the electronics, they cut off the communications, and then they just start messing with people using microwave weapons and other black technology that we don't see usually and people just think is a conspiracy theory. Barack and Michelle Obama directed this. Why in the world would a president, an ex-president, be directing a movie like this that literally shows everything I've ever talked about in videos in action, in effect? Do you see what I'm saying? It's a warning. It's a precursor. It's predictive programming. They do this all the time. But this, and then you have the movie Civil War 2024, which literally shows civil war in America in 2024. Now, this movie was completely and utterly pointless. It made no sense at all. They didn't tell you how the war started. They didn't tell you who was on which side. They didn't tell you anything. And after I watched it several times and just kept looking and looking and looking, I figured out what the point was. They're driving across the country simply to get the president, simply to get video of the president getting shot to death. That was it. And then right after this came out, someone finally took a shot at ex-president Donald Trump. Coincidence? No, it pretty much called that one. But that's not all. Recently, I found another movie called War Games. And it's literally a movie that won at Sundance Film Festival, which I don't even understand that, but whatever. But what they're doing is wargaming exactly how they will respond January 6th of 2025, because they think the election will be stolen. Do you see what I'm saying? And the funny thing about this particular movie, everybody that's in this movie is actual, you know, General Wesley Clark, actual Secret Service, actual House of Representatives, actual governors. These are all actual people that would be in this real life event, but it's somehow a movie. But what they're doing is practicing what to do when, you know, Donald Trump will be elected. Kamala and her buddy are going to lose, but I guarantee you they're going to turn that on its head. So what I'm telling you is they're going to cause January 6, 2025. And right now, they're practicing for it. Trump will win, and they'll take it away from him one way or another because they're going to set this off. And the bad thing about this is, if you can't see the forest for the trees, it's right here in front of your face. They're making all the moves that are absolutely necessary to make sure that they're safe and we're dead if we do anything about it. They're showing you absolutely everything. They're showing it in DOD directives. They're showing it in legislation. They're showing it every single solitary way possible. And now they're practicing right in front of your face.
See, foam task force. They're set up to cover any arrival. They move the ambulances over here too. I guess that's a sign we're going to have aircraft actually landing. For VIP transport, but U.S. Air Force Hueys, basically, used for VIP transport, but also the muscles handle continuity of government operations. So having them as part of this exercise is, well, common sense, I guess.
So not only have they put all the directives, legislation, and made all the moves that they have to make, they're now practicing getting their people out of there. One way or another. So I guarantee you that they will cause an incident in the election, period. They're already talking about not being able to count the votes the first night. Why would they even say something like that? That doesn't even make any sense. You know what I mean? They're going to steal this and they're going to cause a civil war. These people want a civil war. This is exactly why they've been flooding the country with people that do not belong here whatsoever at all. And people, it's not like these people are political asylum seekers. These are criminals coming from other countries that are going, hey, America seems to have lost her entire mind. And they're allowing us to flood their country with our worst people. And that's exactly what they're doing. And then when these people come over here and do exactly what they do, it gets covered up one way or the other. They can do whatever they want and then they get released. Why do you think that is? Why do you think the national debt has gone up? In the last month, I've actually used the national debt as just an example. And I just realized in the last month, it's gone up $2 trillion. $2 trillion. Look at that number. Just absolutely skyrocketing. Skyrocketing. This is insane. Look at these numbers down here. 1960, GDP to federal debt percentage, 50. 34 in 1980. 2000, 55. Now, 122.43%. They're at an all-you-can-eat, and they are just draining all the wealth that might be remaining in the American citizen, in the American system right now, and they're reallocating it to their pals all over the country and all over the world. These dudes are doing this. This is happening right now. You know what I'm saying? They actually put out a 28th Amendment, like I said before. You got to give me a break because it's early, and this is crazy that this is happening. But this is exactly what they would have to do if they want to do this and then implement this. You know, your government just literally gave the military the right to use lethal force, including death and serious bodily injury, against you and your family. You don't know how this is going to be carried out. You don't know how you're going to be perceived as a threat. Do you see what I'm saying? Because they perceive everything as a threat. The government does everything that protects the government and nothing that helps out the citizens of America. And if you haven't seen that yet, I just don't know what to tell you. But I had to put this video out. I don't care if the channel gets taken down. It is what it is. I just don't care anymore because I don't give a shit about my YouTube channel when the country is literally on the verge of civil war. And that's exactly where we're at. And if you don't see it, you're never going to see it. And it's just too bad because you, my friends, have been warned and you are now part of the problem.
Somebody says, I heard an EBS test on the radio several different times today. Did any of you guys hear EBS test? And then they had this like other area where this video doesn't show it, but more people was getting images and clips, and we got some more of that coming up inside this video. Remember what the lawmakers just told us they was looking at a couple weeks back. Let's look at this really quick. This is another section right here of the area where you can see like these cars.
I got to give a huge shout out to JWTV because somebody sent me this link first thing this morning. I'm on my way to go work on my vehicle, hopefully, and I get sidetracked by this. But to tell you the truth, this is a little bit more important than my truck leaking gear oil. This is more important than anything. These guys are making moves. Well, I should say, they've made the moves, and now they're practicing. Now they are practicing. This is huge. This is huge. You see what I'm saying? Unbelievable. At any rate, be ready. You've been warned. I've been warning you for the longest time, and my track record on deciphering what these really mean and what they'll really do has been pretty damn good. This is crazy. This shouldn't be happening in America, but sadly, right now, America is upside down. Richie from Boston, I'm out.